Hey everybody, welcome back to another Motivation Monday podcast for Monday, November 6th, 2017. So today I wanted to talk a little bit about the tradition. And the tradition in jazz is such an important thing. I think a lot of us kind of overlook, including myself, the rich, rich history of this music that we have and how amazing it is. A lot of times I get caught up in listening to the more modern guys, and I'll go, you know, down the rabbit hole of only checking stuff out that has come out, you know, this year or the past 5 years or something like that, because it's really interesting seeing where the modern jazz musicians are pushing the boundaries of music is amazing. And I'm definitely not saying that you should stop listening to the modern guys and hearing where music is going currently, but I think it's also really important that we dedicate a portion of our listening time and our study time to the tradition and looking back to find our way forward. So think about this for a second. The 1920s in New Orleans was really when this music started to become what we would call jazz. You know, before that, it came out of the tradition of the blues, and then before that, it came out of the tradition of spirituals. So if you really trace that lineage back throughout the years, you discover this amazingly rich history, and it really informs the music that is being played and released and the stuff that we're practicing today. So this week, my advice is to go back and listen to some people that maybe you haven't checked out before. So have all of you out there checked out Louis Armstrong? I mean, he's really the godfather of everything that came after him. He revolutionized the way that we play jazz. I mean, he was a world-famous superstar back when he was in his heyday. And it's really important to go back and study some of his music and study some of the things that he did that really brought this music forward. You know, jazz is such a rich historical art form that I think we do ourselves a disservice if we haven't checked it out. Now, one thing that has prevented me in the past from listening to this stuff is actually just the quality of the recordings. You know, they're extremely primitive. The recording technology back in the 20s, 30s, 40s was really not even close to what it is today. So we're kind of spoiled now when we listen to records, modern day records. The fidelity is amazing. So if you're trying to go back and listen to some of, you know, Louis Armstrong's Hot 5 and Hot 7 recordings, you might get turned off immediately by just the quality of the sound. But I wanted to kind of stress that you need to get past that and you need to listen to some of those things and discover some of those sounds that he was using. The other thing is you have to look at it in context. The stuff that Louis Armstrong was playing back then, I mean, it will always be fantastic, but it doesn't hit us like it would have if you listened to that record in the 1930s, right? I mean, this was stuff that nobody had ever heard before. This was groundbreaking material. So, you know, there's a few things that might hold us back as modern day musicians from going back and checking out that stuff from almost a century ago. But I think it is so, so, so important. And once you really get into it, it can kind of take over and you really, really will start to enjoy that stuff. But it's almost like an acquired taste, right? You have to sort of force yourself to sit down and initially listen to it before you really discover how amazing it was. So what I'm going to do this week is I'm going to make a Spotify playlist and post it in the Facebook group so that you can go back and listen to some of these recordings that I think are just absolutely essential and really changed the face of this music that we know and love and are trying to get better at every single week, so that you can go back and discover some of that stuff. So people like Louis Armstrong, Sidney Bechet, those are two big New Orleans musicians that you should all be checking out. You know, New Orleans was the hotbed of this music when it first started to make its way from, you know, blues to what we would now classify as jazz. So Sidney Bechet, Louis Armstrong, Coleman Hawkins, Lester Young, Bix Beiderbecke. There's so many of these guys that I feel like with a lot of my young students these days, these guys aren't even on their radar. And I think that that's a real shame. I'm sure a lot of you musicians out there that have been around for a little bit longer have eventually gotten around to checking this stuff out. But have you ever really, you know, taken a really deep dive into this kind of what we would call old school stuff? So I'm going to make that playlist. I'm going to put it out. And you guys should dedicate a portion of your listening time to maybe this playlist or diving a little bit deeper into some of those people that I've just mentioned. I think it'll really enrich your experience with jazz to kind of see where it all started and check out some of that tradition. Not to mention even transcribing some of this stuff and really finding out what makes it tick. And I will say that I am definitely not standing on a soapbox here telling you all to do this because I was exactly what I'm saying not to be years ago. I would never listen to this stuff. And to tell you the truth, it really was the recording quality. And I just figured, you know, well, I want to sound just like Coltrane. So why am I listening to anybody besides Coltrane and some of his contemporaries? But what I didn't realize was you have to go back and you have to check out who influenced Coltrane or who influenced the person who influenced Coltrane, right? And you need to trace that lineage all the way back to the beginning of this music. So, you know, I am guilty of it myself, but I started playing in a band that really plays a lot of this music from the 20s, 30s, 40s, and is New Orleans-centric. And I got to tell you, it really just enriched my life as a musician. I can't even tell you how much that it did. It opened my eyes to a whole new world of music and a way of playing that really benefits my more modern sensibilities. And I think that's what's lacking from a lot of the young musicians or inexperienced musicians out there is that they just haven't gone back and checked that stuff out. All right. So look out for that Spotify playlist. I'll be posting it on the Facebook group this week and try to dedicate a little portion of time every day or a big portion of time every day to checking out some of the stuff on this. And I think you'll get a huge benefit from it. All right. Send me any questions you have. If there's any topics you would like me to address on these Monday podcasts, I would love to dive into some stuff that's really actually concerning you lately. So email me 10minutejazzlesson@gmail.com. And thank you to everybody who has gone on to Patreon and donated to us every month. You guys are fantastic and keeping us in business. If you haven't done that already, go on to our website and click on the Patreon link and you can find the donate button there. All right, everybody, we'll see you on Friday with another one, and I hope you have a great and inspired week. Talk to you soon.